Welcome to NIOS Studio. I am Dr. Amrit G. Kumar. I am working as Associate Professor in the Central University of Kerala, located in Kasaragod district of Kerala. Today, we will be discussing about different bodies or different constituent bodies coming under Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Before going into the details of the different bodies which are part of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, let us have a look into what is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is a Government of India's flagship program for achievement of universalization of elementary education. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan was launched in India in the year 2001. In fact, it is a tool to implement right of children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009, which came into force in April 2010. As we all know, primary education has become a very big concern for Government of India since from independence. Our primary education enrollment was very poor and the quality of education also was very poor. To deal with these issues, Government of India was planning for a big project to increase the enrollment in education, and it has come out in the form of SSA in the year 2001. Let us look into what is Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009. The Act of Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009 makes education a fundamental right of every child between the ages of 6 and 14 and specific minimum norms in elementary schools. Before the Act of 2009, education was not a fundamental right. As we know, we have many fundamental rights given by our constitution, out of which education was not a fundamental right till 2009. And it was this Act of Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009 which makes right of an Indian citizen in between 6 years and 14 years of age, education has become a fundamental right. It is implemented, this Right to Education Act is implemented with the state government to cover the entire, the Right to Education Act is implemented in association with state governments to cover the entire country and address the needs of around 192 million children in 1.1 million habitations. As we know, the total children belonging to the age level of 6 to 14 is around 192 million. And to educate these children is a Herculean task for us. And the major purpose of Right to Education Act is to bring all these children to the school with minimum essential quality available in elementary schools. Let us look into different bodies under Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Basically, there are two main bodies under Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. The first one is Block Resource Centers. They are known as BRCs. And the second one is Cluster Resource Centers. They are known as CRCs. Let us look into Block Resource Centers in detail. Block Resource Centers work closely with the District Education Officer and Block Education Officer. As we all know, every district in India has a District Education Office. So it need not be the revenue district. Depending upon the convenience of different states and different districts, there are educational districts. So every educational districts will have an educational officer. And at the same time, there are block education officers. So block resource centers work closely associated with district education officers and block education officers. A block resource center has a special staff of 5 to 7 members who coordinate with the cluster resource centers in carrying out their roles. As we know, in BRC, exclusively there are 5 to 7 staffs, which has to be appointed by the state governments. This staff will coordinate with the cluster resource centers. They work as liaison with cluster resource centers in carrying out their plans and schemes as part of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. An important duty of block resource center is the conduct of in-service training for elementary school teachers. Training for teachers working in primary schools on various disciplines, various subjects, including methods of teaching and pedagogy. So this is an important duty of all the block resource centers. Second, block resource centers provide support to cluster resource centers to manage and improve the functioning of schools. This support mainly include academic support and organizational support. Mainly, when cluster resource centers are in need of academic support in the form of resource person, in the form of resource materials, and so on, the block resource center extend its hands to the cluster resource centers for its functioning. And also, when cluster resource centers are in need of organizing certain programs in support with the block resource centers, of course, block resource centers do lend its hands for the cluster resource centers. In addition to its supports to the cluster resource centers, the block resource centers collaborate with various non-governmental organizations, local authorities, and qualified resource persons in implementing the provisions under Right to Education Act. NGOs are an inevitable part of Indian education system. There are various NGOs in different states working for the improvement of the primary education and also for increasing the enrollment of the primary and elementary education system. So we can see that the block resource centers have no hindrance in working with non-governmental organization and other local bodies and local authorities set up by the local governments. Block resource centers staff members are required to monitor and supervise schools on regular basis. So this is an important duty of the staffs of block resource centers. They are supposed to monitor and supervise the schools on a regular basis. And this monitoring should not happen in such a way that they are a powerful authority and the teachers in the schools are people under this particular block resource center. The power relationship should not be there, but in spite of the power absence of power relationships, the block resource centers and its staff members are supposed to provide all kinds of supports to the teachers working in the primary schools and elementary schools. Block resource centers do conduct a lot of research studies related to schools within its own jurisdiction. And the findings of these researchers made by the block resource centers are shared with the members of the cluster resource centers. And this will help the cluster resource centers in planning, training, and improving the quality of education in the schools within their area. Now let us look into cluster resource centers. The cluster resource centers do have direct interface with all educational agencies conducting programs with the schools and work closely with the district education officer and block education officer. As we have seen that the block resource centers are directly linked with the district education officer and block education officer, cluster resource centers also are being directly linked with district education officers and block education officers. Cluster resource centers are mainly located in a well-equipped school campus, with each center catering 15 to 20 elementary schools under one coordinator. This is very important. When block resource centers have a separate entity, the cluster resource centers are located in a school itself. There will be 15 to 20 elementary schools under a single cluster resource center and its coordinator. The responsibility of the quality of education, quality of teaching, and quality delivery of the contents available in the syllabus. Additional staff, whenever is needed, is provided to cluster resource centers who cover a larger number of schools or located in hard to reach areas. As we know, in many of our cases, in many of the states are unable to set up cluster resource center in different parts because of the number, because of the larger number of schools in a particular area. So to handle such kind of issues, there are certain times where a cluster resource center has to handle more than 20 schools at a time. In such cases, additional support will be given in the form of staff and finance will be given to cluster resource centers. And in certain cases, in our nation, we know that the India, the major portion of India is a village. So when a village area which is not been well connected by road or by other means of communication, the government will waive the total number of 15 to 20 condition for a cluster resource center, and thereby there are chances that cluster resource centers will be working with more than 15 to 20 primary or elementary schools under one coordinator. Now let us look into what is the role of cluster resource centers or duties of cluster resource centers. Their main duty is to visit schools regularly and provide academic support to the teachers at the classroom level. As we have seen in case of block resource centers, they visit schools and monitor schools regularly. But in case of cluster resource centers, they are supposed to visit and provide needed supports to the members of the staff of the cluster resource centers are supposed to provide academic support to the teachers at the classroom level. So, for example, if the teacher is in need of certain kinds of teaching aid or any kind of academic support to clarify some doubts of a student or to clarify a content which is provided in the textbook, in all these cases, the cluster resource centers act as a great support for the teachers and schools. Another important duty of cluster resource center is to ensure admission of children in age-appropriate classes in schools. In India, we know that the enrollment ratio in our nation is very less when compared to many of the developed nations. The main purpose of SSA, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, is to improve the enrollment ratio in the elementary schools. In such cases, it is the responsibility of the cluster resource centers to identify the people who are dropouts or who are not being enrolled in the elementary education system and to bring these children to their age appropriate level in the classes, in the schools of elementary education. And the third important duty of the cluster resource center is to conduct training programs for teachers, especially in areas of remedial teaching and special education. As we have seen that block resource centers also do some kind of in-service training programs, cluster resource centers take up more specific kind of academic support to the teachers working in different elementary schools. Their teaching mainly include, their in-service training mainly include remedial teaching and special education. And of course, subject-specific training program also been provided by cluster resource centers without having an overlap with the block resource centers supports. Encouraging enrollment and retention of children in schools from other cluster also is an important duty of the cluster resource center. Interacting and taking initiatives to improve the management of the school in partnership with the school management committee, teachers, parents, community, and qualified resource persons also is an important duty and responsibility of the cluster resource center. We know that a school is being constituted by many components. After Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, an important agency which works for the monitoring and for the upliftment of the quality of education is school management committee. So cluster resource center has to take in consideration with, so the cluster resource centers has to work in association with the decisions of the school management committee, and it has to provide sometimes the academic advices to school management committee, and of course it has to work in association with the teachers, and difficulties faced by the teachers will be communicated by this forum, and then parents, community, and different qualified resource persons who serve for the improvement of the quality in elementary education system. So let us conclude our discussion by summing up the slides which we have discussed already. So, in the first slide, in the first part, we have seen what is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, what is right to education and its purposes. So, second, we have seen different bodies of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan like block resource centers and cluster resource centers. And then third, we have discussed the duties and responsibilities of block resource centers first in detail. And then second, we discussed the duties and responsibilities of cluster resource centers in detail. So, with this, we conclude this discussion about different bodies under Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Thank you.